I could smell my hat like a wet dog in front of the fire as I made my way back round Red Lion Square. The man in the kids' play area had given up on his picnic and gone somewhere drier to keep himself moist. As I passed the Conway Hall, I saw a woman standing in the doorway. She had blonde hair that came out of a bottle. White-framed sunglasses and what looked like mauve lipstick. It wasn't exactly the weather for shades. The people in London didn't care if you wore a fire bucket for a hat and a swan's feather up your arse. It was one of the reasons I didn't move to the countryside. The woman wore a coat printed with some sort of camouflage pattern, but she didn't quite melt into the background. As I passed, I caught a whiff of something better than the wet wool brim pulled down over my face and turned to her. I put my arms in a gesture of the weather. All I got in return was a tight smile, as though she had teeth that didn't quite fit her mouth. I walked through the rain back to Gray's Inn Road, and nobody else spoke to me either. That was another thing